Hi, welcome back everyone. Today we're listening to the song called 10 Years by Daði og Gagnamagnid from Iceland, if you couldn't tell by the name already. I'm quite excited about this one. I think it's going to be quite out there, so I'm just excited to get going. Let's listen to it. Obviously, this one is live. I just hope it's very clear with the sound design. That's a very effective opening. Rhythm? That's a great melody on the violin there.
We've been together for a decade now.
Yeah.
Still every day I'm loving you more.
Super distinct pluck here on the on the synth bass.
I'd probably do it all the same as before.
And nice harmonies as well. His vocal is so clear in the middle, you know. Good amount of energy here, right from the get-go. This vocal is so hectic. I'm not. It might be a little too much. I'm not sure on that. Nice chords. Is that the. It's the secondary dominant, right? I think. Nice rhythm in the electric guitar, very nice. It's a good contrast with everything else around it. Very good movement in that chorus. I think the song from last year had a more memorable melody in that sense. But this one has a nicer movement, I think. The harmonies are such a key part of this, I like them a lot. I've got the drums. The drums are like super engaging. And very distinctly sounding, even in the live performance, you know. Synth solo here. Nice how the guitar kind of puts the backing rhythm towards it. I'm like, ah. It's a nice contrast of sounds. I'm not really getting the cohesion here, but it's quite creative how they've mixed up the parts so differently from each other. Great string use there, it's very disco-like in the strings here, kind of making the elevation in the final chorus here. That's how we end. And that super long drag note on the bit. Alright. Yeah. Okay, that was the song 10 Years from Iceland. And it was, I mean, obviously, it's very reminiscent of what they had last year. Quite similar in many aspects, but I think that this one is has done some things differently, which maybe might be a little bit controversial for the general listener. Maybe I think that the previous one had a more instant kind of catchy appeal to it. However, this one I think has more of a of an analytically potentially analytically interesting song to dive into, because there are I think there are more things going on in this one, and generally I'm just getting a wider sense of a song here. The cohesion, however, is not really what I expected. I think that it's very chopped up in a sense in the different segments, and that's obviously like a stylistic choice to an extent. Because it wants to showcase these different approaches in the music, but it kind of loosens me a little bit because I'm not really getting into the general groove of the entire thing. However, I think, you know, the general ideas of this one are so out there and, you know, unusual in a sense, that it's just quite enjoyable to really get dragged into it. I just f think that where it falls short a little bit this time around is the instant catchiness of a melody, which I don't feel like this song has to the same extent that he had last year. I know I shouldn't compare with last year, but I think that the melody is somewhat forgettable in a sense, at least now on my first listen, because I can't remember it. I'm mostly just hooked on the sound design and the whole approach on that thing. And of course, they want to make it more memorable with these dances and whatnot they have on stage, and the little different just stage presence and performance in general. And that's charming, but I think that it takes away some parts from the actual brilliance of the music making behind this, because it does already have all of those creative, kind of a little bit wacky ideas in there. And you don't need to really hide them by a charming little fun performance. I get that it's a nice combination and it works together really nicely. But at the point, I kind of felt like this took away something from the general songwriting of things. So maybe the songwriting isn't what should be in focus on this song. But I think that it had the potential to be that. And maybe with more... straight to the point forward, simpler, a simpler approach to the melody, this could have stood out even more and made a greater imprint. But I'm just super critical right now because I expected so much greatness, and I got a lot of greatness. I just felt like there was a little further plateau that could have been reached. But all in all, it's really enjoyable. I really think so. And it's so different compared to everything else, and you know, you just gotta appreciate the ideas and the input and the approach they've taken. So great things all around. Harmonies, super big plus, because they're so well layered in this song, I think. So that's like the big massive plus. And I'm liking how this like wacky sound design is really in focus. It's quite unusual, but it's you know, still well polished and well produced, so it doesn't take anything away from the professional sound of it, you know. I think those are my general first thoughts on this one. I'm a bit... I kind of stumble on my words a lot here because I'm not... It's a lot to take in and a lot to delve through. But I think those are my main ideas at the moment. So now I want to read what everyone else has to say on this song. So do leave your opinions in the comments, and I'm looking forward to reading them. Other than that, I hope to see you in the next one. So take care until then, and bye-bye.